Hi, I'm Dave Marsden of Cardiff Theosophical Society. This quick blast of Theosophy is about karma and the individual. This extract is taken from the article entitled Karma by William Quan Judge, published in The Path, December 1886. Although it may at first appear that nothing can be more fatalistic than this doctrine, yet little consideration will show that in reality this is not the case. Karma is twofold, hidden and manifest. Karma is the man that is, karma is his action. True that each action is a cause from which evolves the countless ramifications of effect in time and space. That which ye sow, ye reap. In some sphere of action the harvest will be gathered. It is necessary that the man of action should realize this truth. It is equally necessary that the manifestations of this law in the operations of karma should be clearly apprehended. Karma, broadly speaking, may be said to be the continuance of the nature of the act. And each act contains within itself the past and future. Every defect which can be realized from an act must be implicit in the act itself, or it could never come into existence. Effect is but the nature of the act, and cannot exist distinct from its cause. Karma only produces the manifestation of that which already exists. Being action, it has its operation in time. And karma may therefore be said to be the same action from another point of time. It must, moreover, be evident that not only is there a relation between the cause and the effect, but there must also be a relation between the cause and the individual who experiences the effect. If it were otherwise, any man would reap the effect of the actions of any other man. We may sometimes appear to reap the effects of the actions of others, but this is only apparent. In point of fact, it is our own action. None else compels, none other holds that ye live and die. It is therefore necessary, in order to understand the nature of karma and its relation to the individual, to consider action in all its aspects. Every act proceeds from the mind. Beyond the mind there is no action and therefore no karma. The basis of every act is desire. The plane of desire or egotism is itself action and the matrix of every act. This plane may be considered as non-manifest, yet having a dual manifestation in what we call cause and effect, that is, the act and its consequences. In reality, both the act and its consequences are the effect, the cause being on the plane of desire. Desire is therefore the basis of action in its first manifestation on the physical plane, and desire determines the continuation of the act in its karmic relation to the individual. For a man to be free from the effects of karma of any act, he must have passed to a state no longer yielding a basis in which that act can inhere. The ripples in the water caused by the action of the stone will extend to the furthest limits of its expanse, but no further. They are bounded by the shore. Their course is ended when there is no longer a basis or suitable medium in which they can inhere. They expend their force and are not. Karma is, therefore, as dependent upon the present personality for its fulfilment as it was upon the former for the first initial act. An illustration may be given which will help explain this. A seed, say for instance mustard, will produce a mustard tree and nothing else. But in order that it should be produced, it is necessary that the cooperation of soil and culture should be equally present. Without the seed, however much the ground may be tilled and watered, it will not bring forth the plant, but the seed is equally inoperative without the joint action of the soil and culture. Please note that all my quick blasts of Theosophy are presented as ideas for consideration. Thank you.